All right, it is a nice, cool morning. Might not even be 60 degrees, probably 58, 59. Man, it feels good out here. Kate and I are gonna tag team and stain the new carport. Probably take us a few hours. We're probably not gonna do the actual plywood. You know, there's nails sticking through from the roof shingles. And I may not have enough stain, so we're just going to get the posts, the girders, the 4x4s, and the support boards. So, yep, get all this stain while we have access to everything before we start moving stuff back under and kind of going through stuff and putting it under here for storage. Might get my pressure washer and lawnmower, maybe a couple other things from in the shed and store them over here. So, yep, so we will get started. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
It's My Love.
That was a job, Subs.
Yeah.
Let me go see what time it is. I think it's 2.
Yeah, like 2. We started at... No, this is... It just records the video time. Yeah, we did everything except the underside of the plywood. Because all these nails. And... Yeah, we just put one coat. Kate went ahead and put 2 coats on the 6x6 posts because they're going to be exposed to more elements than the underside here. So we just did 1 coat. But man, 2 o'clock. So we started at what, 7:30? Yeah. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2. So about almost six hours. Pretty much nonstop, no breaks. Except for when I had to run to Ace for a little bit to get some rollers, because trying to paint this with a brush, man, that was slow as all get out. Spent $20 on like 4 rollers, 7 hours. Oh yeah, yeah, another handle. We got a 4-inch roller. We already had 3-inch, but I got a couple more in case we needed them. We didn't need these long ones because, well, they're just too wide for these boards. So yeah, these trim ones and 3-inch brush to help get in the crevices. And this is all, dude. Yeah. So now we're going to take a break. My girl was going to make some spaghetti bake, but I told her, no, you don't need to. I'm going to order probably, what you want, Chinese? Yeah, she wants Chinese. So, because she... Yeah.
Everything is done. You know, everything is finished.
Yeah, that it is.
You know, I put a double coat on the front because that's going to get, you know, most of the weather back there, not so much. But I still did it back there too.
Just yeah.
But most of these here want to catch the brunt of the storms and everything.
Yeah. So.
Yeah.
I got stuck a few times. No. Yeah, sprayers are messy though. They leave a mess all over the concrete. So really doing it by hand is probably the best. Oh yeah, you made a mess. Yeah, she spilled. Oh, we got most of it up. The paint thinner actually did a good job. Yeah, she had a spillage.
Yeah.
Yeah. She got that little paint pan off balance. But
I've done it, Seth.
Yeah. That's all right. That's the only boo-boo. I mean, honestly, we did pretty good.
Well, most of this is going to be cleaned up. Not today.
No.
It's going to be cleaned up. I'll get the leaf blower and blow all this garbage out of here. Everything else, these tarps. Well, I'm going to use these tarps to put stuff away. Store, you know, put over the tables and everything, the benches. Well, if I bring the benches in here, well, I'm going to have to throw a tarp over.
Well, yeah, once I get... I'm probably going to put something like the washing machine, the swing, tires, you know, some of the big stuff I'm probably put up against the wall. I might use that other piece of marble and set up a shelf over here where it was stored before. Just make a little shelf over here with that marble. That table I think we'll keep. Well, we're going to continue to use unless somebody wants to buy it. But, yeah.
Yeah, because I can use this for my plant.
Yep, sure could. So, yeah, this would be a nice arts and crafts table.
Elephant ear, that has to be separated, but
oh, yeah.
Not today.
No, we're calling it a day. I mean, for Labor Day.
That's it, Sunday.
Yeah.
Maybe,
yeah.
Maybe next week, you know,
yeah.
Try to transplant some of my plants. It is September, so I'm going to have to be, you know, winterized to get ready for summer. They're ready to go to sleep.
Yeah.
So,
now, I have some sheets of plywood that were left over from the roof of the carport here. What I'm going to do with those is run them along the side of the mega shed. See, I've got privacy lattice, but water can get in there. And now with this extra runoff from the carport, I want to cover that up, or as much of it as possible, to minimize water getting underneath the mega shed or Kate's cottage. So I've already got strips. I got enough of them to tack up, but I'll probably do that maybe later or tomorrow. I mean, both of us are whipped right now from this project, so.
Yeah. I didn't know what it was. That's a branch bud.
Oh, really? No, oh, yeah, we got branches up our.
You were closer to the door. And
yeah. No. So there you go.
Yep, last accomplishment of the year.
Yep, staining our brand new carport. What are you talking about?
Well, the Halloween stuff.
Oh yeah, I gave her some ideas. Since she's getting a whole bunch of decorations for Halloween, I'm like, why don't you hang some stuff up? You know, we can put some hooks up and she can hang some spiders and ghouls and stuff. So it could be a spooky carport. Kate's spooky carport. Yeah, that'd be an interesting project.
Yeah, that's another one you said. I take my time.
Yeah. Yeah, we're not doing anything more today. We're going to order. Well, we're going to order some Chinese. We'll clean up this mess later. Probably dump a little bit of stain. I mean, out of a 5-gallon bucket, we've still got a little bit in there. I mean, that might be enough to do the front of the gate, and then that'll empty that bucket.
Yeah, that'll be done.
Yep. So, tell you what. No. 5-gallon. No, that 5-gallon bucket, I tell you what, I've bought these in the past. Yep. For those curious, this is Flood. CWFUV. This is a cedar color. 5-gallon bucket. Got it from Home Depot. So, yeah, I love this stain. We've been using it.
Was that last year?
No, I think we got it 2 years ago.
Did we get that 2 years ago?
It was almost 2 years ago, yeah, because you went with me to Home Depot. We stocked up because you were doing the decks. You were doing the staining all the decks and all that.
I did, yeah.
And that one.
Well, I used what you put in, and it was 3 1-gallons.
Yeah. It was like 4 1-gallons.
Some of them were, one was full, the others sort of were not. But I used those first on this deck.
Yeah.
That deck got 2 coatings. Then I did the porch.
Mm-hmm.
That got 2 coatings. Then I did that porch.
Yeah.
Last year. And I got 2 coats. And then I did this. I gave this 3 coats.
Yeah.
Because it was like a wear and tear back there.
So.
There's no covered porch.
Yeah, and all of it was the same Flood color,
yeah, this
or
is
cedar
what
color.
I used for the back deck here on the house.
So this is really good stain, so I highly recommend it.
It's really good. I so, love it. But that's the color stain I'm going to be doing for.
Yeah, so I'm going to wrap this here video up because I got a lot of video clips to put together, and y'all can watch us work, and we're going to go order some Chinese and chill.
Well, we're so, going to take a nice hike. My back and my shoulder's killing me,
Slim. Oh, man, mine too.
So I got
yeah. I'm not as young as I used to be, that's for sure.
I mean, I'm trying to do it as long as I can, but as the years go by, of course, I'm not going to be able to do, you know, work like this.
Yeah.
But I'll still, you know, be able to work with my plants and everything, so I'm going to do about that. But after doing stuff like this, I'm glad it's all done, because in a few years, so I probably wouldn't be able to do it.
Yeah.
So I'm glad I'm able, you know, to do it now, because, you know, I'm getting older. But,
so, all right, well, we'll wrap this up, and until next time, adios.